So here's something interesting that I found. So this is, I had Doris Devine on the witness stand. She tested under oath. She testified under oath that she did not know, Diane, and that she didn't know Diane at all. So I had her on the witness stand, and she testified under oath that she did not know Diane, that she had never talked to Diane. So here's the whole conversation on Facebook where she lied that she had never talked to Diane about me or Shannon, that she didn't know Shannon. So here's the whole text message conversation off of Facebook from back in February that I found. So here's the whole conversation. So she didn't know Shannon. She didn't know me. She didn't know Diane. But here's the whole conversation. Not to mention that she claimed that she didn't know TC, but yet they used to all hang out together. They used to all hang out together. Diane, TC, Alan, Smiley. So, how could none of you guys know TC? So, that's a bunch of damn lies. And then she goes on to degrade, and I don't mean a little bit, I mean to degrade the hell out of TC. This is his own wife doing this. To degrade him over and over. And I mean, it was nonstop. And it was more. I found more. But she testified under oath that she had never talked to Diane, that she didn't know Diane. Then she testified under oath that she didn't even know me. So if you don't know me, this lady's testifying under oath that she does not know me, that she never met me. This was recent. So if you don't know me, and you live in California, then why are you flying back and forth, filing false charges on me if you don't know me? And Judge Doherty agreed with that. And he's not the only judge to agree with that. So that's another question everybody has. So there you have it. So if you're testifying under oath that you don't know all these people. You have a whole lengthy conversation with a bunch of them. You don't know Aaron. You don't know Diane. You don't know all these people, really? You sure do have a whole conversation going on. Because you sure do. You don't do Facebook. You don't do Messenger. Yes, you do. You don't do internet, social media. Yes, you do. There is nothing. This lady is crazy. This lady is psycho crazy. You understand how psycho crazy this lady is? And look at, they feed right into it. They feed right into it. TC feeds into it too. I don't know what TC's issue is for him to do all this shit that he did to me because his wife told him to. Obviously, he does everything his wife tells him to do. Just like my attorney said, he was a pussy. Because that's exactly what he is. But there you have it. More lies. More lies. You don't know me, but you're filing false charges on me. There you go. So here was the other conversation between TC and Kelly. This was a conversation. No wonder people take the laws into their own hands. And TC's like, me too. Which brings us back to these again. So they said, I had a weapon in the courthouse. So you can't bring a weapon into the courthouse. So this is a violation of protective order when I didn't have a protective order. So this brings us back to this again when you can't be somewhere that you're not. You see this? This happens again. Then, when you look down on the names that they put down for the protective orders, doesn't even match any of the names from the very first protective order from back in June of 2017. Because now there's more kids. Ones that she claims she didn't even have. Ones that she testified under oath that didn't exist. So instead of four kids, there's five. Just to bring that to your attention as well. Okay, so this is a picture that was taken of 910 East Ocean View Avenue. This was taken the very next day after they had me arrested back in August of 2017. You see that picture right there? That is the back porch light. There's no damage done to the porch light or the freaking AC unit. All those marks right there down the side of the house, all them black marks, that's where Mike Seamster was throwing crap because the balcony was being repaired. So they were throwing, him and TC were throwing stuff off the roof, and it was landing on top of the AC unit, and there was a bunch of stuff. So TC had gotten a letter from the condo association, which is on file, where he was ordered to clean up all that debris from the condo association, ordering him to clean up all that debris, okay? So that's where all the marks came from. They're saying I did this the night that they arrested me. They're saying that I did all this damage to the siding. I guess I had a damn extension ladder in my pocket because that's three damn floors. So they tried to say I did this. The light is not busted and there's no damage done to the AC unit. None. There's no bullet holes. There's no nothing. And you see that damn window's covered. You see that shit? Those windows are covered. So how the hell are you going to see somebody on the second floor walking around at 3 o'clock in the morning? You see the windows are all covered? You see that shit? So they're a bunch of damn liars. So that was the other thing. I just wanted to point that out. They do stuff like this. They make fake profiles. They use fake profiles, but they use my picture. They use fake names. They make fake profile accounts in my name. But see, they're idiots because this will go back to their IP address. Because every electronic device has its own IP address. But that's my picture that they use, but this is the name that they use. So I don't know who this person is, so it must be pretty close to somebody that they know. But I don't know what this ha 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 whatever this is right here. So I don't know what this is. But that was kind of messed up. They do this kind of shit all the time, just to let you. Then I have people who do shit like this to me, who accuse me of stuff, who say I don't pay my bills, but then when I say, hey, you know you can come down here and do this and look at my bills, they don't want to do it. But they don't want to apologize when they get caught. So then I send them copies of my bills where my shit's in my name and that is paid. But they still don't want to apologize. But then they want to try to evict me out of my house when they get caught doing negative and shady shit. Because then you got TC stalking me on YouTube doing shit like this. So it causes problems every time I have a place to live. Then you got Tracy, who's doing the same shit because she thinks that she's a seamster. But then there you have TC doing that shit again.